Hey, what's happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. So right now, we're actually outside of Jolly's little inn right here. I don't know, the world is named Jolly Roger's Lagoon after all, so maybe we'll pop him a visit. But first, let's actually jump into a lake-infested water. Who's with me? That sounds like fun, so let's just do that. Because there are some coins that we missed in the bottom of the little area right here. And like I mentioned before, we really can't do anything about all this gook. And as you can see, I had 23 doubloons before I got these four down here. I actually did something bad while I was recording. My last recording crashed, so I actually learned a move and got four doubloons. Sorry about that. I'll actually just show it off now because I feel kind of bad. And the numbers are a little askew, but I'll just show you what the new move is and go to the area where you can learn it and show off where those doubloons actually were. So yeah, let's just do that. And basically, while I go over there, if you hit the X button now with Kazooie, you learn the Wing Whack attack. But I'll let Jam Jars explain it better, because he's usually into that kind of thing. Let's see here. The Wing Whack allows Kazooie to defend herself when she's on her own. Press X when running, jumping, or standing still. And we get our life filled up. So cool. And four doubloons would surround him, and yeah, that's pretty cool. So now Kazooie can actually defend herself. She's not actually useless. She still has a little, not as much health as Banjo, and is pretty vulnerable, but at least she can attack now. She can fend for herself. She's a strong, independent woman. Okay. But anyway, let's head into Jolly's right now, and let's see if he's a happy kind of guy. I don't know. His name is Jolly, after all, so let's just jump on his counter. Oh, hello there. I'm Jolly Roger, town mayor and proprietor of this lovely Harborside Inn. We'd like a ginger beer, please. Yeah, on the rocks. I'd like to oblige, but I'm less than jolly at the moment as my partner's gone missing. That's a shame. Now how about that drink? Kazooie! Oh, sorry. Where did you last see her? She was out on a wave racer earlier, yesterday evening. I heard a big gulping noise, and when I got outside, she was gone. Perhaps she was eaten by a vicious sea demon. Oh, Kazooie. Oh, I hope not. It's happy hour soon, and I'll be needing some help. Aw, would you like to rent a room? It's half price at two doubloons as this naughty mole has dug a hole in the corner of it. How about it? Okay, my partner just got eaten by a sea demon. She's been missing a couple days. Hey, do you want to stay in a room? Like, dude, I know you can get over grief that fast, but that's a quick change of the subject. But you know what? Aye, let's get that room. Let's totally disregard your partner's disappearance and whatnot. And it's only two doubloons, and lovely. I'll just open the door for you, okay? Yes, opening the door will forget my past memories. Cheers, but how can you possibly sleep? My partner is still missing. Oh, okay, he has a soul. Huh. Kermit, Mr. Jolly Kermit has a soul. I don't know. For his voice, I just went a little basic right there. I could have just went the Kermit, but you know, everyone probably would have went that way, so that's why I zigzagged on that. And let's see, what we got in here? Gunpowder. Wow, Jolly's packing heat. All right, so let's see. Grenade egg, gunpowder. Let's blow it up! Oh my god! Jolly, I'm so sorry. I had no idea that effect would happen. Who knew shooting a grenade at gunpowder would make it explode? Well, I knew it, Jolly. And I will smash the rest of your building if you do not cooperate. Okay, he did cooperate. He gave me an inn, so that's definitely cool. And this is the mole that dug a hole up in here. Don't know why he did it here exactly. I guess he wanted to stay here for free. Oh, Jam Jars, you really are the best sergeant ever. When in the water and baddies attack, this new move will let you shoot back. Press Y for the aiming sight, followed by LT or Arch to start a fight. I don't want to start a fight. That'll be all, and dismissed. Yeah, he missed. Ah, Jam Jars, that's what you get for going in the inn without paying. You know what? Crime doesn't pay, especially when you're in the military, okay? But anyway, yes, that is the egg aiming sight underwater. We can now shoot eggs underwater. Pretty rad right there. And nice little fireplace. Imagine like fireplaces that were like that in real life. They were just poofs of flame. Jesus, man. And we got a jukebox over here. Oh, whoa. I'm afraid our jukebox is broken at the moment. A real pity. I just love dancing to the salty semen shanty. What? Perhaps you'll find a way to fix it. Oh my, I don't want to do that shanty. I'm scared. I'm going in this room. Oh, we got a treasure chest. Hey, a picture of Treasure Trove Cove. Cool. Ooh, it's this guy. Avast there, ye scurvy dogs. I be Captain Black Eye, fearless pirate and scourge of the seas. You're looking a little tight, a little wobbly there, Blackie. Just a touch of seasickness, ya filthy rats. Seasick? Some pirate you are. Watch your tongue, buzzard. Alright, this guy is actually pretty unique, and let's keep talking to him and we'll find out why.
Shiver me timbers! These seasick tablets Jolly gave me are mighty useless!
Let's talk to him again.
Splice the main brace! One more press o' that bare button, and I'll run ye through!
Fourth wall breaking right there, let's talk to him again!
Right! I'll slit your... Oh, my poor stomach. Just take these doubloons and fetch me some... another glass of, water.
So yeah, we get 3 doubloons from Captain Black Eye. You got all the doubloons. Nice, well done. Just for that, you can now have a new gamer picture. Oh, gotta love the Xbox 360 or Xbox Live Arcade version. And yeah, that's Shark Food Island back there, and there's a Stop and Swap egg over there. But basically, this guy right here is, it's pretty important. This was the main villain of Project Dream, also known as Banjo-Kazooie. This guy was Grunty. I were in this fine game, and right here he's going to say some things about how he was in the game, the bear stole his glory. Arr, I had a dream once, Project Dream right there. Talk to him again. Arr, I had a dream once. Okay, you just said that. You have old timers? Arr, I had a dream once. Okay, we get it, Captain Black Eye. You had a dream. You're not Martin Luther King over here. But basically, he'll say, like, a bear stole his glory once, but yeah, that was the main villain of Project Dream, and basically, the story behind that game is it was on the SNES and being developed, and the main character's name was Edison, a boy, living in a pirate village, or setting out to save his girlfriend or whatnot, and he had a rabbit sidekick. So yeah, it eventually evolved into Banjo-Kazooie after Banjo was one of the characters originally, and they found him more interesting than that, and decided to make a game around him, and they... basically made Project Dream toward the end of the SNES cycle, and it was an RPG. They really just decided to make it a platformer, and they kept most of the music, actually. I believe one of the tunes is in DK64, but I'm just rambling on right here. I could talk all day about Project Dream because I really know all like the backstory of Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie, because after all, I made the Stop and Swap video, so I think I'm pretty informative on this stuff, and it just really intrigues me. But anyway, let's look at this menu. Okay, today's specials. Salty dumplings, $3, okay. Toad in the hole. That sounds nasty, that's $4. Semen surprise, $5. Jolly! Just give me the ginger beer, at least that's not suggestive. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright, so we wasted enough time in there. Already had freaking, 7:45, jeez, man. Let's actually go to Pono, get that jiggy. Because now we have all the balloons, I think we have well more than enough to get this nice little jig right here. Let's do a little jig knot. Pono's Emporium, and let's talk to Rick, Pono. Greetings, friend. The name's Pono. I'm the local pawnbroker. We're interested in that jiggy in the case. Ah, yes, a real nice piece of circa Banjo-Kazooie, so I was told, and I'm getting a sense of deja vu right here. Must be from that last loaded file I had. I guess I didn't talk to him then. Again, Choying Doubloons, blah, 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 blah. We're having deja vu. We're stuck in a loop. It's still Choying Doubloons for the jiggy. Would you like to buy it? What do you say? I love how the B option's gnaw. Like, nah, man. Alright, friend, let's have some gold, and there you go, 20 doubloons, and a pleasure doing business. Please help yourselves. I saw that register all day today at work, and 12? It was 20 doubloons. I can see it reversing as 21, but where'd you get 12 from? That's a weird kind of thing. I guess 1, 2, but... anyway, with the power of register, it shatters the glass, and we got a jiggy. I wish we had those at work, but anyway... so we got the jiggy from Pono. Basically, we're pretty much done with the overworld section of Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Didn't expect it to take 2 parts, but then again, the last part, it was really a half part in here, so it was like 1.5 parts, and a lot of people actually liked that I extended the time to like 20 minutes, so maybe I'll make the parts a little longer, but not too long. Alright, so welcome again, Baron Bird. Let's give him the Globo. I think we have 2 Globos, so we're really digging in that. One of the Globos is for the overworld, but then again, it doesn't matter. They're all Globos in the end. And let's see, we'll give him the Globo, and Mumbo will do probably his most powerful spell and most useful spell in the whole entire game, because without it, it makes this world nearly impossible. And I actually tried doing this world originally without his help, and I saw quickly that it was nearly impossible. But I was a brave lad back then, but now I live by the book, and I will do things the Mumbo way. So take it away, Mumbo, step on that pad, and let's do it. Hope this works.
Bing bong 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 b
And there we go! Mumbo shine big light on water. It now has plenty oxygen. Barren bird not need to hold breath in the where. Now, the where, okay. Messed up there, but anyway, basically we could breathe underwater now. Best water world ever, it's just like Donkey Kong Country. But yeah, that makes this world 100 times better. If they did that in Super Mario 64 with the, I think it was actually called Jolly Roger's Lagoon in that one, or just Jolly Roger's, I don't know. Jolly Roger's Bay. This is a lagoon, there's a difference. I wonder if it was a throwback to that. Oh, who knows, but yeah, you had to hold your breath, and coins somehow made you gain breath. That never made sense to me. Which way do I go? Okay, good. We go this way. That way was to the turtle. Alright, so we're at a Mumbo skull, and we are actually ready to swim underwater and make our way into the main area of Jolly Roger's Lagoon. If you thought this was it, no it's not. We're actually going to dive into the meat and potatoes of it, and knowing that fish, oh man, that fish teaching me how to swim faster, a lifesaver in this. And Mumbo, thanks for telling me how to breathe underwater. Awesome. Alright, so basically we have this little object over here. We can't really do anything with it. It has Kazooie's face on it, so that'll be a move we learn actually later. And if you shoot these guys with ice eggs, they actually repress their tentacles. And they're going to be a little nice to us. And this one has eggs. I believe this one has the... There we go. That has the notes. And there we go. Wow, I'm actually getting pretty accurate with my egg aiming. Usually I'm not a good shot, but anyway, let's see what we gotta do here. What we wanna do here is actually go down this cave, and when we reach these calamari guys, they're just waving their hands, just having a good time. You know what? Freeze! Okay. Freeze, dirtbag! Okay, but why'd I do a Police Academy reference? But anyway, let's go into the Blue Abyss, and here we are. The lost world of Atlantis. Okay. I was gonna cue Jurassic Park music, but no. It's just Atlantis. I feel like Atlantis is like the most unoriginal idea to name any water area because I just feel like everyone does Atlantis. At least Futurama, they actually named, they did like a parody of Atlantis, but they named it Atlanta. The lost city of Atlanta. I thought that was funny. Yeah, we just gotta destroy these blowfish. Basically, if they come near us, they'll expand and it'll not be a fun time. And enough swimming in circles. Well, actually, what are we gonna do first? Oh, God! Okay, it showed what it can do. Let's blow it up. Grenades, underwater, physics, okay. But anyway, we actually can do one jiggy here. I don't want to make this part too long, so let's just go to this door right here. Let's see, we got a horseshoe, pie, triangle, squiggle, horseshoe, pie, okay. It repeats. So horseshoe, pie, triangle, squiggle. I actually tried doing this puzzle. I forgot that it actually gives you the what you have to do, so... Yeah, you might want to read that door before you tackle this, so let's see here. Just hear it. Oh, wait. Pie? Pie? Okay, I think I already did pie. Maybe that's why it's beeping. Oh, no, it's horseshoe pie. Okay. Horseshoe? Pie? Squiggle? No, okay. Horseshoe pie, that squiggle, then horseshoe pie. Okay. I'm really bad at these, like, little memory puzzles. I don't know. I never always had the best memory, so... Yeah, it reflects here. I would always write it down, even if it was like a little password system. Like in, I remember in Goof Troop, I would always write down that password, like cherry banana, whatever. And it was like the easiest password system too, and I would always forget, but nonetheless. And pie, okay, good. I think there's Greek symbols too, I don't know. It uses a lot of that kind of thing. It's Atlantis after all, they want to make it a little more exotic and whatnot. It's an ancient city after all, and let's see, here we go. This is the door we just opened, and let's go inside. Alright, so this is the Temple of Fishes. A little area, but there is something of importance. We got a guy up here in a little shark tank. Let's see what's up with him. Ah, he's wearing like little Great Britain shorts. And hi, I'm Chris. Chris, not very pig-like if you ask me. Actually, it's Crispy Bacon. Oh, I see. It all makes sense. What are you doing, Mr. Bacon? Mr. Kevin Bacon? I'm on vacation trying to photograph those lovely paintings on the wall down there. Sounds fascinating. Oh, it is, but these awful fish keep attacking me. Why not get a spare gun? This camera was way too expensive. I had no doubloons left. We could have spared him some. We had 7. Perhaps you could protect me while I'm down there instead. Yeah, sure. Oh, it's no I and nay? Right then, if you could just follow me down to the bottom. Yeah, why didn't you buy a spear gun? We could have funded it for you, but you know what? Guns are bad, I don't know. Especially down here. Like, the spear gun would probably travel very slowly underwater. It's not really gun physics underwater. But then again, it's Banjo-Kazooie, so why are we arguing that? And let's just get on top of the cage, you'll see why. Hope you're ready, here they come. All right, basically we gotta protect this guy with our lives. Basically, the strategy here is go on top of his cage and you should have a nice little 360 panoramic view of all the fish and if I can, actually, okay, good. I was a little panicked there. I think I shoot through that rope, so it doesn't matter if that's there. All right, we're getting a little close for comfort. We still have 40 seconds. Yeah, this is pretty hard based on the camera. Like, the egg aiming sight is cool, I mean, but it's really just a pain in the ass when it always goes back to the center. So I just find aiming with the eggs in this game, just doing shots, is really, really sensitive and really difficult at times. And especially when you're underwater and you gotta deal with that, it can be a little annoying. So let's just keep going in a circle. We're doing pretty good right now. We're not letting them get too close because if they get right next to the cage, it's over and he'll go back to the surface and we'll have to just crawl over again. So that's not fun. And let's see, we have any more. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we're good. And we'll destroy you anyway. And there you go, you got all your pictures? I think that will do. I'm off back to the surface. And there he goes. Oh god, I clipped it like to the side of him. Jeez, thanks a lot, bud. You better have a jiggy for that. I love his little Great Britain shorts. I guess that's a rare reference, obviously. That's where they're stationed. Or were stationed, unfortunately. I got all the shots I needed. Perhaps this thing I found earlier may interest you. Yup, a jiggy. It's made of gold. I think that would have funded your spear gun project. Well, I'm off to get these pictures printed. Bye. Alright, see you later, Mr. Crispy Bacon. Go say hi to Kevin for me. He obviously would know him. Come on, the 4 degrees or 5 degrees of Kevin Bacon or whatnot? He knows everyone. So anyway, yes, we got the jiggy in here, and we are done in here because that's all it has to offer. And I think we'll end it here because the part's getting a little long. So anyway, thank you guys for watching. Next time on the Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. I mean Banjo-Tooie. I don't know how I messed that up, but Banjo-Kazooie, what not. Anyway, we'll be tackling Atlantis, the meat and potatoes of it, because we really just touched the surface, and there's a lot to do in this world, so we'll be seeing what it has to offer. Another word I've been using a lot, offer. But anyway, I will see you later, guys, and until next time on Let's Play Again, Banjo-Tooie. Got it right. Only 10 notes away from 100. See you then.